story. Something to get off my chest. My life's kind of boring. Do something that I can't confess. Till on my sleeves I stain red from all the truths that I've said. Come by it honestly, I swear. Thought you saw me waking up. I've been on the brink, so tell me what you want to hear.
Houston, how we doing? This is, and I gotta say, this is cool because it's the another one we came through here in the summer, completely different venue. This is a lot more intimate, and I think this is the appropriate way to finish the year going into Christmas. I think we've done about 120, 130 shows this year. This is the final show that we're doing this year. Thank you, by the way. The weather's amazing. It's freezing in Boston. It's beautiful down here. We've been a band for 16 years, which is longer than a fair amount of marriages in this room. Facts. Whatever. Get over it. It's okay. And in 16 years, we've done a lot of different styles of tours. Support this album, support this single, you know, themed tours. And we got to this one. This is a radio show. It's a unique, this isn't a normal concept for us. This is a lot of different artists. It's obviously put on by a radio station that we and you love. So we thought, you know what? We love radio. We grew up listening to it. It informed who we are as a band. So tonight, our objective is not to play a bunch of random album stuff that's just for our enjoyment. We're trying to play hits tonight, if that's okay. Yeah. That's the purpose of tonight. So we're calling this the Mostly Hits Christmas Tour. My goal is that by the end of this show, if we do 14, 15 songs, you know 13 of them. That's the objective. And to the two or three geniuses that bought tickets thinking this was One Direction. And I say that every night because statistically speaking, every single night there's at least two or three of you. I'm sorry, there are no refunds, but we have way more hits, so I think you'll be okay. And I know, we're the same age, the same. We look the same, it's confusing. I wouldn't do the same thing. It's the, you know, right? It's the internet. Okay, so let's jump into it, right? We're gonna rip through this. This is the second song we ever put out. If you know this song, you have shopped at a Whole Foods. could I see? A star. Brent Cutsell on cello. Eddie Ray Fisher on drums and Brian Willett on keyboard. So, as I said earlier, we've been a band for a long time now. January will be our 16th year playing. Our first show we ever played, the five of us, was the homecoming for USC on like January 7th, and it was one of the few days where it basically snowed in LA, so it was freezing. And I'll never forget that because, you know, we walked into, we had no idea what was gonna happen. Definitely didn't think we'd be here in 16 years, but I'm thrilled for it. And in that same time period, longer than 16 years, to keep the lights on, to pay the bills, I had a day job writing songs for hundreds of other artists around the world. Some of you know this, some of you don't. You got the handful of One Direction geniuses in the crowd, that's fine. Story of my life. And then you have people here in this crowd that are the age range of our fans is a beautiful thing because it goes from like 3 to 90. So we have some people born in the crowd that were born well after 2010. And so they only know the last 3 or 4 songs we did. So, but here's what I'm gonna do. I had this idea at the beginning of this run that started this summer, right when the inflation started going nuts. I thought, man, we gotta hedge against this. Inflation's gnarly, man. Gas is going up, milk, bread, houses plummeting. What can we do as OneRepublic to hedge against this? And I thought, okay, people come to see our songs. I'm gonna hit them with a free concert in the middle of the concert. So what I'm gonna do in the next 15 minutes, I'm gonna play like 6 or 7 number one songs I wrote for other people.
Wow.
Some of these I wrote with other people, some I wrote for other people, wow. Other artists. Lucky enough to write with and have songs come out with everybody from Ozzy Osbourne to Taylor Swift.
Wow.
Paul McCartney and Peter Gabriel to Ed Sheeran. And everybody from, it goes a long way. Beyonce to Adele, yeah. Some country records in there too. Carrie Underwood, Lady A. So I don't have time to do all these. A lot of these became hits, against anybody's better judgment. They came out and they turned into hits and you know them. So what I'm gonna try to do in the next 15 minutes, I'm gonna try and skip through some choruses and we're gonna play Name That Tune for about 15 minutes, okay? I did not sing these as well as most of the artists that put them out. However, there's 2 or 3 of them. Well, it's questionable, maybe. Okay, I've done a lot of songs over the years with, for Beyonce. Houston, represent. But the first song I ever did, we're gonna jump straight into it, then I'm gonna shut up and I'm gonna rip through them. But the first song I ever did for her, it was a really extremely rare situation. She called me and said, I want you to write me a song. This almost never happens. Artists don't do that. They don't call and say, it's not. Back in the day, Sinatra would call his favorite songwriters and say, hey man, I need you to write me a tune, right? Nobody does that anymore. She called me and she said, I'm in a relationship. It's really special. He means a lot. I love him. I think this one's gonna be the real deal. This is like 2009. And I said, and I didn't know who she was with, so I Googled Beyonce is dating ? And it said, Beyonce is married to Jay-Z. And I thought, damn, she pulled one on me. She's married to this guy, all right. So I love Jay-Z in a completely different way than she does. Dirt Off Your Shoulders is maybe the greatest song of all time.
Oh.
It's the theme song of my life. But this next song here, this is, I wrote this with a buddy of mine, Evan Bogart, the two of us. This is our love letter to Jay-Z. Oh. And it goes like this. If you know this, feel free to sing along. Thank you.
never really had a doubt. Standing in the light of the halo, I got my angel now. It's like I've been awakened. Every word I just break it. It's the risk that I'm taking. I ain't ever gonna shut you out.
Hop jump through the last 15, 16 years. I told you number one song, so we're only playing number ones. Here we go. This next song, believe it or not, came out before Halo, and then we're going to jump after Halo and then go on from there. This is the song that got me out of a efficiency apartment on the edge of Koreatown. It goes like this.
I don't care what they say, I'm in love with you. They try to pull me away, but they don't know the truth. My heart's crippled by the pain that I keep on closing. You cut me open and I keep bleeding. Keep bleeding.
Keep me alive.
Oh, you kept me
song I wrote with Brett on the cello back here. There was this barrage in 2008 to 2012, where if you remember, if you listen to Brett, some of you were just born, it's fine. It's fine. You're gonna live to be 150, whatever. But it was all British, it was like the British invasion. It was like Amy Winehouse, then it was Leona with Bleeding Love, and then it was Adele, and then it was just one UK actor after the other. Well, we jumped on that bandwagon because when it comes to writing songs, I'm a whore. And dance music had just blown up, and I thought, you know what? I'm sick of writing ballads. All anybody did was call me for ballads. That was becoming the one-trick pony, write the ballad. And I want to do dance music, man. Every single song that came out at that time, every song was, I'm on a roundest club, I'm on a bus all night, I want a something black, like it was kind of, right? But that was like 35,000 songs, and like, I did none of them. And so we sat down and said, we got to figure out dance music, let's do something different, let's write a different type of dance record. And we wrote it on a tour bus in Chicago, and then a year later it came out and went number one, and this is a song. Over the years, started with 21. I did Turning Tables. That was the first song we did. Did stuff on 25. The second song we did though is this one right here. And she came into the studio. She's smoking a cigarette. Nobody does that anymore. Nobody does that. So it was really interesting. So she walks in smoking and she's in a mood, and if you know anything about the album 21, it's about one guy who sucked so bad that a girl wrote an album and sold 50 million copies of it. That's a true story. That's how bad this guy sucked. So all of the songs were like, it was like a raw nerve, a breakup, and she just, every day she walked in, she had something to say. It was amazing. The best thing you can do for writing on a Tuesday is get divorced on Monday. And I'm not supporting divorce. I'm just saying, like, whatever the worst thing is that can happen, that raw nerve is what I access and what songwriters need. I need you to walk in with a raw nerve about something. You could be happy, and we write Pharrell Happy. Or you could be sad, and we write this song. So she walks up, she's pissed off, she's smoking, she says, I don't want to do a song today, I'm not really in the mood, I'm not in the mood, not in the mood, not in the mood. So what would happen? Well, I was talking with my friends in Tottenham, in London, and they were saying, oh, do you know what? I heard about you, Adele. So rumour has it you've done this. Rumour has it you've been with this person. Rumour has it you were making out with so-and-so. You were hooking up with this person. Rumour has it. I said, okay, let's write that song. Let's write Rumour Has It. It's an interesting, and I'm looking, you know, her song titles are really weird. They're really cool. Chasing Pavements, Turning Tables, Rolling in the Deep. What does any of it mean? I have no idea. But Rumour Has It, spelled with the U and the O because she's British, spelled incorrectly. So she asked me, right before the album came out, do you mind if I spell it the proper way? And I was like, no, that's not proper. I'll let you spell it incorrectly, but I'm fine with it as long as you credit me as the writer. So this is the song we came up with. I did the melody. She did the lyric, most of it. We just kind of went back and forth. It goes, she ain't real. She ain't gonna be able to love you like I will. She is a stranger. You and I have history, oh, don't you remember? We got time for maybe one or two more. There's some other stuff there's some country stuff. There's some, a couple songs I did along the years from Maroon 5, like.
Maroon 5?
I really wanna love somebody. I really wanna dance the night away. I know you take me halfway there, but you can take me all the way. You can take me all the way. And, I'm following the map that leads to you, the map that leads to you, and nothing I can do, the map that leads to you. Following, yeah.
Wow.
And we don't have time for one of my favorite ones. They went something like this. I'm a sucker for you.
Wow.
See the way I'm not going anywhere, baby. I'm a sucker for you. Let's do this one. So this one came out. Yes, man, just play those chords. There it is. Speaking of radio show and radio in general, I found out last week on this song. I don't get to say this that often because it doesn't happen that often. But this was the most played song in America in 2022. So I think you're gonna know it. Some of the fans out here, younger fans. You're gonna know this one. I'm sorry. I've been playing stuff that's like 2008, 2009. They're like, we weren't born yet. Well, you'll know this one. He's from Atlanta. He conquered the world in the last 4 years, and he's one of the most interesting human beings and talented people to work with. And we did this song with some friends of ours. It goes like this. I want We'd like to thank a handful of people for having us here tonight. That's okay. We still have a couple more songs. I think you're gonna know them. But this was put on by Mix 96.5, and they've been big supporters of us from day one. So we'd like to give a round of applause for them for holding this concert tonight. I'd like to thank Ireland puts out a disproportionate amount of talented singers, whether it's going back to, you know, obviously Bono and U2, Hozier, who I think is one of the greatest singers of all time, and then Dermot Kennedy. Long tradition of buskers with ridiculous, particular voices. And also the band Camino, big round of applause as well. Given that this is the last show, you know, Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays. And if any of you guys, next year, we're not doing too many shows in the US because we did a full US outdoor shed arena tour this summer. If you missed it, I'm sorry. But, COVID's over, so if you want to travel and have a destination, a reason to travel, starting in February, we're playing all of Southeast Asia, Australia, New Zealand. And then next summer, outdoor festivals in Europe. Come see us in Italy, France, Norway, Poland, you know, whatever. Just come see us. We have a couple more songs. This next song I wrote for my kid when he was 1 year old. I had to write him a song. I thought, man, I've written more songs than I can count. 1,000-something songs for way too many people. And I have kids now, and I haven't written anything for them. And you know, I thought, did you just take a shot of something very strong? Are we doing Christmas shots? Is that what we're doing? I'll tell you what, I don't know about a shot, but if we could get some local Houston beer on stage, I would happily. Somebody hands me a Bud Light Seltzer, I'd be a little.
Bud Light Seltzer, lime cranberry, it's amazing!
Oh, here's a cup of something. Let's go ahead and raise a glass. If you have a cup in your hand, happy holidays, everybody. Thanks for hanging with us tonight. I see some Stella, I see some Liquid Death.
It looks like alcohol, but it's not. Go ahead.
I know, you're driving. You know what? God bless you. Here we go. Cheers. Happy holiday.
Liquid Death. Drink the water.
Guys, this is called I Lived.
Jump, you don't fear the fall. I hope when the water rises, you build a wall. I hope when the crowd screams out, they're screaming your name. I hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. Yeah.
So if you have any battery left in your phone,
lights,
and you have a light,
light, turn it on.
Let's make some stars real quick.
Thank you. sink in the river, the lessons I learned. Baby, take that blood, watch it burn. Sink in the river, the lessons I learned. Baby, take that blood, watch it burn. Sink in the river, the lessons I learned.
OneRepublic from Colorado Springs, Colorado. I had always wanted to see them live. I remember playing Guitar Hero, and now I know why their songs were so reminiscent, because I used to play them all the time. And I'm so glad I was able to make it out here. Oh my God, the lead singer is so talented. Amazing songwriter, has written for so many artists, and it was refreshing to see that we were able to sing most of the songs, as well as the ones he's written for other artists. But I think it was a great experience. Hadn't been out to Bayou Music Center in a matter of years, actually. Last time I came to this venue was either for Soooo or for Snow Patrol. So I'm very glad I was able to make it out here. Dermot Kennedy from Dublin, Ireland. That's the first band that opened the night. Well, soloist, right? The band, Camino, second band. And to top it all off, to close out the night, was OneRepublic. Amazing experience. I think we all enjoyed it. I think you're gonna enjoy this amazing set from this amazing band. And please make sure that you follow them on the social media. OneRepublic, the band Camino, and Dermot Kennedy. Amazing artists, and I gotta admit, OneRepublic was special. I had always wanted to see them live. And I finally got the chance to see them live. You can always follow us on Facebook, Rockfest Houston, Twitter, Rockfest H, Instagram, Rockfest Houston Radio, TikTok, Rockfest Houston Radio. Just now, created a Snapchat account, Rockfest Houston there, and of course YouTube. where you could find, hopefully, tonight's set of all three performances, as well as many other ones that I've been able to catch live throughout the years. I've been told I have the best channel out there, the best channel as far as live music, and I gotta admit, I think they're not wrong. I have great content, 1080p, great variety of content, diverse content, and I'm glad that you guys were able to come across this video. Follow. Feel free to follow, share, like this and all the performances from tonight here at Bayou Music Center, Houston, Texas, downtown in the museum district. Wish you guys a good night and take care. I'll be seeing you guys later. Future events that I'll be attending: Incubus 713 Music Hall on the 2323, Papa Roach, Falling in Reverse, Escape to Fate, and Hollywood Undead 21723, also at 713 Music Hall. What else? Muse, March 2nd at Toyota Music Center. Where else? The Killers, March 23rd, Toyota Center as well. Other events: Red Hot Chili Peppers, May 25th, Mid-Atlantic Park. I believe these are all, most of these are events that Live Nation has put together, like this one. And what can I tell you? It was well worth the money invested tonight. And I'm hoping that you guys enjoy these sets. Take care, and I'll be talking to you guys later. Bye.